Every journey in space starts on the homepage. It's a personal dashboard that shows the information that matters the most. You can see meetings for today, absences, and birthdays. It's a good summary of what my day will look like. You can also see the teams I work with, favorite projects, code reviews that need my attention, and the latest news from the company. What's the team doing today? We can dive in and then look at today's team schedule. You can also see who's in the team, see everyone's role, or start a chat from here. Each team can write a little bit about themselves. Combined with the overview of people on the team, this is very useful when you need to find someone in the company to help you with a certain task. Space also shows the projects a team works on. Projects in Space are where people work together. They come with general tools that can be used by anyone in your organization, like checklists, issues, boards, and documents. On top of that, Space provides specific tools for certain types of work. For software development teams, Space comes with Git repositories, code reviews, continuous integration through automation, and package repositories, so you can store Docker images, Maven, NuGet, or NPM packages. Space is self-service for everyone. There's no need for administrators to create projects or repositories. Everyone in your organization can do this themselves. Team members can create a new Git repository. Repositories can be initialized in Space, but there are some other options available as well. You can make a one-time copy of another repository or set up a bi-directional sync so you can use both repositories at the same time. For any repository, you can see the latest commits and filter where needed. You can look at the details of a commit and look at the changes that were in there. You can display branches and you can look at all files in the repository. Under files, you will see all directories and code. You can clone the repository in an IDE or just browse it directly in Space and expand folders and dive into the source code. People can add comments to the repository, which everyone can see. This can be very helpful to give some background about existing code that is in there. You can also ask questions to other people in Space, right from within this code view. You can mention people as if it were a chat, and in fact, it is a chat. You can continue working on other things and just wait for a response to come in. Responses will be shown in chats. If no additional context is needed, I can respond from here without having to make a full context switch to the actual source code. From any discussion, whether it is in chat or inside code, you can also create an issue directly. You can add it to a specific project and then add more information, and then of course create the issue. Many things in Space will start a focused chat, much like this code discussion. If you add a comment to an issue, others can see it in chat and they can respond there as well, without having to open the issue at hand. Issues can have a title and a description. You can assign them to people, set a status, add attachments, and all that. The list of issues can be filtered by who is assigned, by date, by status, and by tags. Tags are also hierarchical. For example, you can add a tag by year and month, and then here, filter by only the year. Space comes with issue boards as well, to help visualize work and sprints. They are a great tool to see how the project is doing, to look at the workload for the next sprint, and so on. You can drag issues between statuses too. Another generic tool in Space are checklists. They can be anything, ranging from a very fine-grained task list to high-level planning. Checklists are great to use during meetings to quickly write tasks down. You can reorder and add structure as you see fit. From within a checklist, you can then create issues when needed. Every project has documents to store. In Space, you can keep project documentation, meeting minutes, how-to information, and all that. We use project documents to keep track of everything the team decides, so we can work more asynchronously. In these days of remote work, often on different schedules, this reduces the amount of meetings we require and gives us more focus as a team. Now let's circle back to coding and clone our repository to start working on it. Any Git client can be used here. In the JetBrains IDEs, you can use the Space plugin to make it easier to find out which repositories you have access to. I already did this beforehand, so I can dive in at once. In fact, I already made some changes to this codebase, and I'll make a couple more. I'm working on a separate branch here with the intent of merging changes back to the main branch later on. Let's commit the changes we made and then push them back to Space. Back in Space, you will see the changes have been pushed. To merge them into the main branch, you can create a merge request. A merge request serves as a review by one of the members on your team. When adding them, they will see a chat notification about the code review pop up again. My colleague is now reviewing the code changes I just made. It looks like she's adding comments. I hope everything will be okay and I can merge these changes soon. All right, it looks like the changes were approved. This repository also has a quality gate defined, where a continuous integration job has to complete successfully before being able to merge this branch back. Everything looks good here, so I can safely merge. Another aspect of software development is continuous integration. Space supports running automation jobs to build code, run tests, and deploy to production. After committing or merging code, an automation job can start. For this project, it will compile sources and then publish a ready-to-use package into Space packages. With Space packages, you can host artifacts that can be consumed by folks in your organization or externally. Space can store Docker images and Helm charts, and Maven, NuGet, and NPM packages. For every package that is pushed, history is being tracked. You can see all versions, when they were created, and where. This package here was created by Space Automation, so if needed, I can also navigate back to the build log. But enough about software development. I could use some vacation, so let's create an absence. You can schedule vacation and many other types of absences. And when the world allows for it again, we can schedule business trips. You can set the time periods and the location you are traveling to. So if you have multiple offices, this makes it very easy for folks to figure out where to find you to grab a coffee. The more information you have available in Space, the more valuable it becomes to you and your organization. Having absence information in Space makes it clear when someone is unavailable. Space lets us schedule meetings too. Pick a time slot, and then add individuals or the entire team at once. In the timeline, you can immediately see which times would work to start a meeting. Conference rooms are optional, but if you do need them, Space will suggest them based on where folks are joining from. Let's schedule an after work that people can join if they are interested. You can do so using the privacy settings of this meeting. And then copy the meeting URL. When you paste that URL in a chat, the meeting will unfurl and folks can RSVP right from within this chat channel. Chat is a great way to communicate with people. We've already seen chat being used for code and issues, but of course regular chat is there as well. You can create public and private channels and start conversations with one or multiple other people. Frequently used channels can be pinned, so you can easily find them at the top of the list. You can also pin threads. This makes switching to an ongoing thread much easier and faster. Speaking of chats, this message here is something that I will follow up on later. How do I keep track? Well, in Space you can add this to the to-do list. In chat messages, issues, and blog posts, you can click the lightning bolt to do so. To-do items can be accessed from the left sidebar, where you can keep track of things to follow up at a later time. Actually, let's move this one to tomorrow. In the to-do list, you can also show meetings of the day. This gives you quick access to your schedule wherever you are in space, just from the sidebar. On the homepage, you may have already seen some blog posts. Blogs are a great way to broadcast information. Blogs can be shared with everyone in the organization or with specific teams or locations. For example, this post here is targeted at folks in a specific office. Blogs can have events attached, so they have both context and an actual invitation. People can RSVP, add comments or ask questions, and that again will open a chat with the authors of this post. There's a lot of information in space, but also a powerful contextual search. You can search for teams, people, projects, repos, and quickly find where you want to go. There are many, many features and integrations in space, but if you do miss something, there is a very extensive API that you can use to integrate other applications. Integrations can be interactive too. They can interact with users in your organization using commands and interactive chats. Find out more about space on our website. Sign up for your own space and give it a try.